chapter 24 and 37. It says, but as the days of Noah were, so also the coming of the Son of Man shall be.
So it says, what 20 days of Noah? Because guess what? When the Lord talked to Noah to build the ark, a lot of people didn't believe that water was going to fall from the sky.
God.
Right? But this time, it ain't going to be water going to fall from the sky. It's going to be fire.
Check.
You understand? Right. Which is the nuclear bombs that the Most High put in the heart of the so-called Germans to make. Right. Right? Go ahead.
It says, for as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving into marriage,
right,
the marriage, until the day that Noah entered the ark.
Yeah, and guess what? Our ark is about love. Is the name of the Most High Yahweh.
Done.
Because guess what? His name is that Lord, righteous, walking, running, set, and shall be saved.
That's right.
You understand? Yeah. You understand?
This Amos chapter 6 verse 1 says, woe to them that are ease in Zion and trust in the mountain of Samaria, which are named chief of the nation, to whom the house of Israel came.
Yeah, which is with the trusting on mountains of Samaria. You understand? First of all, it's all the false words and the state of America. For you people trust in America. You understand? Guess what? Where your gods? Outside Israel. Where is the people that you trust in? Right? Who is man that thou shalt fear man? You understand? Trust in the Most High that can destroy your body and soul. You understand?
Sorry.
This is Leviticus chapter 20 verse 13. Every man also lie with mankind as he lies with a woman.
So the scripture says, if a man lies with a man, he will lie with a woman, right?
And both of them have committed an abomination.
Both of them committed an abomination.
Second Peter 2, 7. We love righteous love. Yes, I'm sorry, we put to death.
The scripture says, if a man lie with mankind, he may lie with a woman. This system today push that man lying with man is a good thing. This system today push woman lying with woman is a good thing. You understand? That is wrong according to the scriptures that you go say.
That's right.
But then you will take the Bible, the Holy Bible, and go in on that damn court system, put your hand on it and swear on it. And see how you believe in God and all these God-fearing people.
But read it over again now. This is Leviticus chapter 20, verse 13. If a man also lie with mankind, as he lies with a woman.
So if a man lie with mankind, the way how he lies with a woman,
both of them have committed an abomination.
Both of them have committed an abomination, which is a filthy, disgusting act in the eyesight and the Most High. And America, the United States of America, passed laws where it's okay for a man to lie with mankind as he lie with a woman. Understand? The passed laws saying that it's okay. Go ahead, son.
This is Romans chapter 1 and verse 24. It says, wherefore, power also gave them up to uncleanness.
But really and truly, the Most High gave all over to that nasty and filthy act. You know why? Because all you're rebellious.
Man.
So he said, the hell with all you, all you're just vessels fit for destruction.
That's right.
It says, through the lust of their own hearts, to be dishonored, their own bodies between themselves, who changed the truth of power into a lie, and worship and serve the creature more than the creator.
Yeah, or you serve the creature more than the creator. Or you serve the ways of this world more than what made this world. The ways of this world teaching all you have to be unrighteous. And I'm talking about the people on that side here.
Right.
Because Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, so they're the only people the Most I care about.
That's right.
You don't care about other nations.
you only care about those people.
That's right.
You understand? So, when you choose to follow this system, when you choose to go down that line, instead of following your Basham, your Sheikh,
that's
right. So, destruction for you, boy.
It says, for this cause, power gave them up unto vile affections.
Vile affections, boy.
For even their women, they change the natural use into which is against nature.
Right, so what is a woman natural use? To take a man. That is natural use. The beginning there was made male and female. But this system and this topic of, because there are a lot of homosexuals walking around here. You understand? This system teach. That is okay for a man to lie with a man and a woman to lie carnally with a woman. So the most I gave all you over to vile affection. So all of your lesbians out here shall surely be put to death.
That's right.
They're becoming dead.
That's right.
All of your homosexuals shall surely be put to death.
That's right.
Understand, man? What?
It says, and likewise, also the men live in the natural use of the woman, burning in their lust.
Burning in their nasty, disgusting lust toward a man. That is why the most I do all that.
One towards another, men with men, working that which is unseemly, to receive in themselves that recompense of their error which was met.
Yeah, the error, the recompense what you're going to receive is thermal nuclear destruction and destruction of the chariots, so-called UFOs.
That's right.
And the most side, because you come with your own special brand of fire to burn all your asses up.
That's right.
Because all you're wicked.
That's right.
So let me see the destruction. But then, let me see what the most side leave for example. Nations who did this thing in the past. What happened to them today?
This is the book of 2 Peter, chapter 2, and start of verse 5. It says, and spared not the old world, but saved Noah, the eighth person, a preacher of righteousness, bringing in the blood upon the world of the ungodly.
Right, so the Most High kill everybody else in the earth, and only save eight souls. Everybody feel the most is just about love and prosperity and peace and just be good and live good. Like bullshit. Most is a mass murderer, because that way saying that he just kill plenty.
Good.
When he kills by the millions. And that's what he's coming to do. That's what he's coming to do on this side of the earth just now. For your vile affection and all your habits, all these nasty man with man, woman with woman. Understand? This is disgusting and quiet.
God, it says, I'm turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes.
Turn them into ashes. What?
Condemn them with an overthrow, making them an example.
Making them an example. You know what's the example? Any nation who ever lived like this, this is what will happen to you.
God.
And America followed the same pattern that Sodom and Gomorrah take.
God.
Because the scriptures say, their vine is as divine as Sodom.
God.
You understand? So America follow that same pattern. You understand? So this is what going to happen to them. Boy.
It says, making them an example unto those that after should live on God, and deliver just lot, vexed with the filthy conversation of the wicked.
So in this system, if he's a righteous person, you're supposed to be vexed with the things you see in the church. Really and truly, you see two men walking with two men. Hey, that off. You're not supposed to be all done with that, because if you're with them, if you're not against them, you're with them. If you're not against the ways of the world, you're with it. Don't hand join in hand. The wicked shall not be unpunished. Understand? Proverbs 11:21. Go ahead.
This is Ecclesiastes 7:7. It says, surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
Yeah, because Jake, like they say, we so wise, and that them Jakes who go in, Huey, that he has to go all kind of degrees, right? I wise, right? The scripture says surely oppression make it a wise man mad. So really and truly they're foolish. The ones who wise is the apostle is a great millstone all the way down.
That's right.
Because we cry until our shine to deliver we from this place.
That's right.
We see a lot of wickedness going on and we want to stop.
Can't.
But righteousness to rule on the earth.
Can't. Right.
And righteousness begins with the Son of the Most High, Yahweh Shai.
Can't.
Understand? He is coming to usher. He's coming to usher in his kingdom on this earth. Understand? Well,
this is Jude chapter 1 verse 7. Even as Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities above them in like manner, giving themselves over to fornication and going after strange flesh, are set forth for an example, suffering the vengeance of eternal fire.
Right, so Sodom and Gomorrah is an example for America. America is spiritually known as Sodom. Revelation 11 and 8 say that. Spiritual Sodom and Egypt. So, drop the verse 4. So if America do that, the Most High going and burn America up. You understand? He's going and burn it up. Right.
Verse 14. And Enoch also the seventh from Abba, Adam, prophesied of thee, saying, behold, Yahweh cometh with 10,000 of his saints to execute judgment upon all, and to convince all that are ungodly among them of all their ungodly deeds which they have ungodly committed, and of all their hard speeches which ungodly sinners have spoken against him.
Right, so Enoch and all prophesying about Yahweh Shai coming back with 10,000 angels to destroy this place.
Okay.
Enoch prophesied about that, that he said from Adam, that even back then. So the doctrine about us as a deliverer, Israel was always out.
Okay.
Always had it. You understand? Enoch and all prophesied that this place had to be destroyed. Right now we're living in the last days, we're living in that time when this place is going to be completely wiped off the face of the earth.
That's right.
And if you're not down on the side of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, hey, start be a portion.
Can.
Because Yahweh Shai is the only way out of here, through the knowledge of him. Because there are people who calling on Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, like these other Israelite groups, the HODC, AOI, the Sicari, all of them just call on Yahweh Shai. But they don't really believe in him. You understand? They don't really believe in him. So it's the right way of believing in him. This is what we're going to get us saved. Because we're looking for salvation. You understand?
It's Matthew 7 verse 21. It says, motherfuckers are high up. It's Matthew 7 verse 15. It says, beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing.
Yep, yep, beware of false prophets. Who's that false prophet? Nathaniel 7, that guy sold out, he's going to lead you to destruction, and they're coming on this promenade and preaching, right where we are here preaching, which is some force, that's some up. You understand? They are false prophets misleading the flock. HODC, Sakari, IUIC again, Peter again,
Yahana.
Right? These fake churches, we know they are off, we know they're off. But then it's a false prophets in Israel who will mislead the flock. Well,
but inwardly they are raving wolves. You shall know them by their fruits.
You shall know them by their fruits. You shall know them by their fruits. They tell them they just take line. They're taking lineups. They go to the barber saloon and get the edge up. That wrong. So if you see that the fruit God made for you sin, you should know that I'm very contrary to the scripture.
They had the women all out of order.
Yeah, had the women all out of
order. Yeah. And they're more worldly. They're more worldly and spiritual.
Yeah.
When you really watch IUIC videos of them in the so-called feast days, or even on the norm, they more portray themselves as worldly people and really and truly portray themselves as Christians. Because that's how Christians is operate. Christians more worldly than actually spiritual, or you can watch them and tell that they're righteous. You understand? It says, you shall know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes of thorns or figs of thistles? Even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, But they corrupt you, create what evil could. Who is that country? Great Millstone.
That's right.
Point blank period. And even if it's not Great Millstone, but you're teaching the same doctrine that others teach, you basically are part of Great Millstone. Because that guys who not really are Great Millstone, but they just push that same doctrine.
Can't.
Great Millstone. So the same fruit that Great Millstone have, that Great Millstone produce, that is the good fruit. The bad fruit is IYC, IYC. Just take first communion. You ever see the video of that?
Yeah.
They had the bread, they had the bread, the flat bread like the Roman Catholic Church.
Yeah.
But really and truly, they are the 501c3.
Right.
So really and truly, they are a sect of the Catholic Church. You understand? Because a branch. Because anytime you license your church, you basically hand over your rights as a pastor or a preacher to the Catholics.
You're not under their wing.
You're not under their order, you're under their wing. That's why they call themselves the mother of all churches. Because you can't go and establish your doctrine without getting permission from them.
To be
acknowledged or recognized in this world.
Right.
It says, every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire.
So IYC going to be destroyed, that whole movement. This Egyptian consciousness, house of consciousness, bullshit movement,
God.
Going and come to end.
Sorry.
Because we ain't from Egypt. That's right. We are from Israel.
And
the other day I told a fella that in my work, I say I'm from Jerusalem, he laughed at the squad. He said, so what are you saying? You're an Israelite. I said, yeah, I'm from Jerusalem, he laughed at the squad. He said, but I'm an African. I said, well, all right, you be African. We are not from Egypt, so that won't be cast down and hewn into the fire. The GOCC won't be cast down and hewn into the fire.
You know, if I may say something real quick too, right? Something unnoticed, because normally when they try to tell somebody, hey, I know from Egypt, you understand, and that you come from the lineage of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and all roots go back to the Bible. You notice that the Bible has too much rules. These other books, they don't have no rules. So they just want to do what? Go up there and live helter skelter and do whatever the hell they want. But all roots come from Egypt, but what proof? Or what prophecy that you have that you could really bring to show that all people, everybody over here came from Egypt? I mean, what's so special about Egypt? The only thing about Egypt that's special is that, hey, that you could show that that was a dynasty back then, that the people were black. I mean, if you're from Egypt, read the hieroglyphs. We say and we proclaim that we are the true Hebrew Israelites of the Bible. And guess what? Men here, we could read Hebrew. We could understand certain things she described at the Most High.
Can.
You understand? All line doesn't come back from Egypt. You understand?
You were saying that how you had a book flawless.
Yeah.
And I think probably really have the Bible.
Yeah.
The Lord and the Heavenly Father. Yeah. So this is Jeremiah 2 verse 5. It says, thus saith the Lord, what iniquity have your fathers found in me, that they have gone far from me, and have walked after vanity, and become vain? And that iniquity is the righteousness of the scriptures. They rather live. Israel always had a desire to be in the other nation. You understand? That's why they come and ask for a king. You understand? And when it comes to the ways, they always go to fallen nations, mainly Egypt. Because there was really brought forth in Egypt as a nation. So they had that ancient custom in them. They look at Egypt as their father, in other words. So they always had that Egypt madness embedded in them.
God, I never gonna say this, you know, like them them Jakes who in the Amazon. Them like real in the Amazon, in the bush, the Jakes and them.
Yeah.
You notice the customs?
Yeah.
Bought a lip white out here, bought a hole in the face. Yeah. Just like Egypt. Just like ancient, because that custom just in them. Like all the north.
And it's mainly in Northern Kingdom, you see doing them kind
of thing. Northern Kingdom, yeah, in the Amazon and thing.
Yeah.
Deep in the rainforest and them tribes.
And they more had a love affair. They more had a love affair with Egypt than And the Southern Kingdom too.
Southern Kingdom, yeah.
They always had that Egypt vibration pushing on them. That's why you'll see when they came across it, they built pyramids and all that. Because they want to remind themselves of ancient Egypt. You know?
pull up on that area.
We'll finish up. I'll go back to the match sheet.